Hi guys, it's me again, Stephanie here. Welcome back to my channel. I'm thinking of starting a series of I attempt videos where I attempt makeup looks, hairstyles, and what else? Whatever I can find on YouTube that I think would be fun to do. So today, I'm trying to recreate a smoky eye makeup for Asian or hooded eyes by Tina Yong. So I'm going to insert a picture here and let's get to it. I've already got my face. I've already got my foundation on and I've already done my eyebrows. So now I'm going to start with primer. Oh yes, I also like to mention that I got one of these for my sister for her birthday, and I also got myself a set because they were on discount. And now I'm going to use them. I guess this could be sort of like a review video for these brushes. And we've got this brush. This is actually a blusher brush, but I'm thinking since I'm using this, which is also from Eco Tools, this is an old version, I'm using this as my blusher brush, so I'm going to use this for my contour. No one said you can't. Alright, so let's get to the eyeshadow. I'm going to cheat and I'm going to use my contour palette by Too Cool for School. This is the palette and I'm going to use this nude shade over my eyes. I don't own much makeup, so these are all the good makeups that I have. I'm sorry guys, if you're hearing a lot of noise from above, that's actually just my dad. He's got his own private gym upstairs, so he's working out. Oh, I don't know what he's doing, but he's making a lot of noise upstairs. So I'm sorry about that. Now I'm going to go with the transition color. She used sort of this type of brown, but a bit more warm color, and I don't really have that color. So guess what I'm going to do? Use this color in the middle for that. And I'm going to apply this on my hood. Is that called the hood? I'm not sure. But she applied it here, so I'm going to do the same. I'm not really seeing a lot of difference. Once you're happy with this color, you just use a darker one, which in my case, I'm going to use this color here at the end. And I'm going to darken this area here. Honestly, I don't know if I'm doing this correctly, but this is a Stephanie attempt video. Yeah, I don't see much difference. So I'm going to go ahead with a darker color. This is a darker color. This is from Elanto. This color is pretty intense, so I'm going to be light-handed with it. And then everything's always fine once you blended it out, so I'm going to blend it. Right, a matte black, and I'm going to use my pinky and I'm going to apply that at the end. I'm going to blend it. Okay, I've got to brush some fallout away. So now you're supposed to do the same thing to the lower line. Black. Okay, and then I'm going to blend it out. And now I'm going to apply eyeliner from Art Deco. It's a high precision liquid liner. I have very oily lids, so my friend introduced this eyeliner to me, and so far I've been loving it. It's really been staying on. So today I feel like I'm going to try something different, and instead of doing a high cap eyeliner, I'm just doing a normal winged one, so it looks a little bit more natural. I noticed that Tina gave a little tip to extend the line all the way to the front, so I'm going to try to tidy up the line that I created. Right guys, my phone ran out of memory and I didn't realize that until I've already highlighted my eyes, and I've applied the Bobbi Brown's matte black eyeshadow under my eyelid, so I mean like at my lash line. I'm gonna apply a little bit more shimmer. This is a bling eye stick from Etude House. I got this quite long ago and I feel like it's very shiny and I really like it, but I haven't been using it often because, I'm not gonna lie, I was actually quite lazy to put on a full face of makeup, but I'm trying to improve myself. She did say to curl my lashes before I draw eyeliner, but sorry, I'm too used to doing it after my eyeliner. Now I'm using my Misha 4D mascara. I just recently bought this from Altea.kr. It's a website where you can purchase a lot of Korean products for a very good price. So I will link that in the description box for you guys if you want to check it out. I actually got a lot of my Korean skincare and makeup from that website because it's really convenient, and at the same time I know they are authentic. So yeah, you guys can check it out. So far I've been loving this mascara because you can really build it and it's not clumpy. And this mascara was very cheap. I think it was like $16.90 is really cheap for a quality mascara like this. I have been building it up these days because I don't have thick eyelashes and neither are them long, so although I must say something, I do recommend this from Etude House. It's a lash serum. It helps your lashes to grow longer and so far it's been working for me. Like I can see significant difference when I use it every night before I go to bed, because you're supposed to leave this on like 8 hours a day. Sometimes in the morning I don't use mascara and then I just put this, and Yeah, I think around like 2 weeks, I've seen really significant changes, especially when I apply mascara. I can really see the difference. And I don't feel like putting mascara on my lower lashes, but since she did that, so I'm going to have to, because this is a recreate the look. Okay, I'm going to contour my face. Also like to apply some down here just to sharpen up my jaw. And now I'm going to put on a little bit of blusher. I'm not going to go too much with the blusher. What do I feel like? I feel like this. Yes, my sister's friend got me this Sol Susan blush, universal blush, but I dropped it and so sad. But I really really love this color. It's really nice. It's like a pinkish coral shade and it's really shimmery. So I noticed that whenever I put on this blusher, I don't really need to apply highlighter. Isn't this color just so beautiful? I really love it. I think I should contour my nose a little bit. So I'm gonna go in with the middle color here and I'm just going to do some contouring. My nose. My nose. And I am going to brighten up this nose of mine. Brighten it up. Oh, I'm brightening it up with this color here. Brighten up my lip. Brighten up my lip. Brighten up my nose. And also shading here. Just a little shade. This fluffy little brush from Eco Tools. I don't think they make this anymore, but this brush changed my life. This brush, like, it's just such a good blending brush. I really love it. And then I'm going to do my lip. What should I do with my lips today? I think I'm going to go with red today because I feel like it could potentially brighten up my face. So I'm going to apply MAC in the shade Relentlessly Red. It's a matte lip color. Can't see the number anymore because it's rubbed off. And then I'm going to use my Maybelline Red Porcelain. I'm going to use my finger. I have to say that this is my favorite red lipstick purchase from Maybelline. It because it's just such a great like blending color with every other shade I have. I love it. I love this color so much. Done, I'm done. I finished it. I think I did a pretty good job. What do you think? Let me know. And if you like, you can also let me know what is the next makeup look that I should recreate for myself. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. I will see you very soon in my next video. Bye.